That's Alex Salmon, of course. Hi, Mr. Salmon. We appreciate you taking the time to do the first broadcast interview with us here at Sky News. Do you think that Nicola Sturgeon should be suspended?
Well, I actually think Humza Yousaf has set a perfectly defensible line. You know, the presumption of innocence. You don't suspend people until they're charged with something, and that hasn't happened as yet. His difficulty, of course, is that wasn't the position adopted by Nicola Sturgeon or Peter Murrell, the chief executive, her husband, when they were in power. I mean, they used to suspend people at the drop of a hat, basically. So, you know, Humza's difficulty is not the position he's taken, which is a perfectly respectable, defensible position. I actually think it's the right position. His problem is it's been compared with a whole litany of other people who feel, quite rightly, they've been treated unfairly in comparison in their cases some years ago.
Humza Yousaf described Nicola Sturgeon yesterday as the best politician in Europe. What do you think?
Well, that wouldn't be quite my description, but nonetheless, I mean, look, there is a bigger issue than this. I mean, Humza really has to depart from the previous administration. He's got to have a clear line of departure as the new First Minister on what he's going to do from what came before. I mean, the SNP's under a substantial financial cloud. It's not going away anytime soon. It's not about one individual. It's a systemic argument about what the SNP's been doing. And therefore, Humza really, and he has to do this pretty quickly, has to set out a new agenda to stamp his mark on being First Minister, as opposed to just being seen as Nicola Sturgeon's candidate, Nicola Sturgeon's successor. He really needs to put his own mark on being First Minister.
OK, what is your view of her as a politician? I'm guessing you're saying she's not the best politician in Europe. What is she?
Well, she had some of the most substantial communication skills that politics, certainly in the UK, have ever seen. But she left a very difficult policy legacy for her successor. She left a rather difficult position on independence by going to the Supreme Court for reasons that no one's been able to fathom, and getting the idea of a Scottish run referendum disallowed. She's left a difficult policy agenda in the Scots Parliament full of, you know, pretty absurd and silly policies like self-identification, closing fishing areas, bottle schemes, you know, abolishing some trials by jury. Now, you're never going to get a majority of Scots behind such policies, and my strong advice to Humza Yousaf is to sweep that nonsense away, concentrate on the key issues of housing, education, health, and restore confidence in the Scottish Government's running of the Scottish Parliament. Get back the reputation for competence and efficiency and common sense that used to be the bulwark of why people respected the Scottish Parliament so much.
So, just to clarify, Mr. Salmon, you're saying that Scotland is further away from independence than ever because of the actions of Nicola Sturgeon, or some of them?
No, I'm not. What I'm saying is we've got to decouple the cause of independence, which is riding high in the opinion polls just now. I mean, a poll yesterday showing at 52%, a poll last week, Morrie, showing at 53%. These are sky-high levels for the support for Scottish independence. This has been the SNP support has taken a dent because of the difficulties that are surrounding that party at the present moment. So the important thing is to tap into that independence support, which is why I'm suggesting there should be an alliance between all the independence parties. The next year's general election in Scotland, there should be fielded one independence candidate in each constituency to maximise the independence vote, and we should downplay the party politics while the SNP is under a cloud.
But you talked about the Supreme Court and the fact that as a result of the ruling by the Supreme Court, you know, there can't be a new Indy ref, and that was back in November, and that was as a direct result of the actions of Nicola Sturgeon appealing to the Supreme Court.
Well, it was a fool's errand to go to the Supreme Court, no question about that. Therefore, you have to find another way of allowing the people of Scotland to express their democratic right of self-determination which wasn't disputed by the Supreme Court or by the UK government, we have to find a ballot box method of allowing people in Scotland the right to choose their own future. My suggestion would be to have general and Scottish elections as that ballot box opportunity, hence the idea of a Scotland United for Independence coalition comprising all of the independence supporting parties, the SNP, which is a dominant party, ALAPA, Greens, Scottish Socialist Party. Let's have one candidate, each constituency, on a manifesto that says we're looking for a popular mandate to negotiate independence from Westminster. And incidentally, there's a poll out today which shows a majority of people in Scotland back that position.
But that's hence, you describe it as a fool's errand. That's hence my point, that because, in your opinion, Nicola Sturgeon did do that fool's errand, Scotland has found themselves in a more challenging position when it comes to any potential independence.
Yes, I should clarify, a fool's errand's a phrase. I'm not suggesting that Nicola Sturgeon's a fool. Clearly, she's not a fool. She was a very capable politician. But going to the Supreme Court was almost a shot at a last gamble, which had no appreciable sign of any possible success. It was like an act almost of desperation. Far, far better if Westminster chooses to block Scotland's aspirations through a referendum, undemocratically, disgracefully, and a few other things you could add, then find another ballot box opportunity in elections. I mean, even this Tory government ain't going to cancel elections anytime soon. And therefore, that ballot box opportunity should be taken next year's Westminster election and the subsequent Scottish elections. After all, before the advent of the Scottish Parliament, that was the route to independence, which was accepted by every UK Prime Minister from Harold Wilson on. It's time to reassert that ballot box opportunity and allow the people of Scotland to democratically vote to determine their own future.
I'm sure you're not suggesting that the Supreme Court is undemocratic, but I wonder if I could ask you whether...
I'm not suggesting it's undemocratic. What I'm suggesting is that perhaps Lady Hale's Supreme Court would have come to a different decision to the present Supreme Court, which seems far more conservatively inclined.
Well, we'll never know. Did Nicola Sturgeon's arrest surprise you?
Not immediately, because you know there are three signatories to the SNP accounts: Peter Murrell, Colin Beattie, Nicola Sturgeon. Both Colin and Peter Murrell had been arrested. Therefore, it would seem that if the signatories to the accounts were being arrested, then you know Nicola was next in line. Now, they were the key office bearers when this financial problem was present and is now being examined. So you would expect the police to continue their investigations without fear or favour. Incidentally, lots of folk are asked about this and they all say you mustn't comment on a live police investigation, and then they proceed to comment on it. I'm the exception. I'm not going to comment on a live police investigation. Just let the police go on with it.
Quick thought before I let you go. Are there any circumstances where you would consider rejoining the SNP?
Well, I'm very content with the role that ALAPA's playing in Scottish politics. We're a growing political party. We're approaching 8,000 members. That makes us, by membership now, the third biggest political party in Scotland, far bigger than Tories or the Liberal Democrats. And that, we believe, will be reflected at the ballot box. And, of course, if we approach the next election as an independence coalition, you'll find a way for the independence-supporting parties to work together to maximise the opportunity in each constituency to return an independent supporting candidate.
So is that a yes or a no to potentially rejoining the SNP?
I'm very content with ALAPA, but I'm very content also to work in cooperation with other people from other parties who believe in the goal of Scottish independence, because that goal transcends party politics.
OK, so you wouldn't join them again, but you might work with them?
Well, that's a very fair summary of the situation in this incidentally gorgeous day in Edinburgh, Kay. You should be here. It's absolutely fantastic, as it always is in Scotland.
I know that from personal experience. It's always great to see you. Thanks for joining us.